Now, I will install the motors on the chassis. I most likely will need these long bolts, some nuts for them, the screwdriver from the set, the motors, and the chassis. I'll start by opening the chassis back. Taking out the chassis. The chassis has those motor mounts as part of the board, so I will start by breaking them out. I'll do it carefully, one by one. The motor mounts have these extra connection points where they were attached to the chassis. They're designed to be broken off. I will use small pliers to clear them out. This is not necessary, but will make the robot look nicer. As you can see, they have a small perforation exactly where you need to break them off. So once when you use the proper tool, they are quite easy to break off. Okay, all of them are now ready. Next, we'll start mounting the motors. Now, let's see where the motors are supposed to go. The two motors, as shown on the picture, supposed to go in those two locations. They're designed so this small pin to go on the outside, and it is shown on the board. To mount the motors, we'll need the long bolts. So I'll take them out, and we'll need four nuts for them. All the nuts in the set appear to be of the same type and are in this small bag. The motor will be mounted with the help of these mounts, so we can start by protruding one of the mounts through the chassis. Placing the other mount like this and protruding the two long bolts through the holes. Then making sure that this mount here goes into the proper slot on the chassis. This looks just slightly tricky, but with little effort we can get it done. Once when this is done, we can put the nuts on this side. This nut should be able to hold it in place. Now I can put the second nut. Here on the bottom. And use a screwdriver. Start tightening into it. It is going quite tight against the board. I think we can easily tighten the nuts now, since this motor appears to be properly mounted in place. Now we'll repeat the same operation with the second motor. The pin goes on the outside. Push the two nuts to the holes. Push them through the holes on the other side. Put nuts on the bolts. Again, this one is going to be slightly more difficult. But I am a little bit more experienced. The bolt is going through the nut. Before we tighten, make sure that the mount goes into its slot here. Continue to tighten the bolt. And both motors are ready. I can use the pliers to tighten the bolts a little more. Actually, for the bottom nut, it is held properly in place by the chassis, so I don't even need the pliers for it. So the two motors should be ready. Now I can connect them to the corresponding connectors, motor right and motor left. Push until they click in place, and this is it. We have the motors properly mounted on the chassis, and this motor driver here is going to drive them later when we power on.